What's up, everybody? Trinity here, and welcome back to the Second Street Marvel. It's New Comic Book Wednesday, and here I am in my local comic book shop, Bases Cards and Comics, right here in Lancaster, California, to bring you all my comic book pull list for the week. Now, if you don't know what a comic book pull list is, that's okay. There should be a video right up there where you can go and learn a little bit more about that. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over Marvel, then I'm going to get into DC, and then small press and indies as usual. So yeah, I guess we're gonna go ahead and get right into it. Now, the one thing I do want to know as we go through this list, what's on your comic book pull list? And, you know, let me know what your thoughts are on any of these titles and any of these books. If there's any you'd like me to do some more deeper dives on, or just anything like that, just let me know all your thoughts down in the comments below. Now, starting off, we're going to start off with this right here, guys. In case you didn't know, Free Comic Book Day was kind of ruined this year, and books have been slowly rolling out into stores, just kind of, you know, just a nice little slow trickle, and that's okay. This week, we got one of the ones I was interested in, and this is the Free Comic Book Day of Blade Runner 2019. Now, I gotta tell you, I wasn't gonna pick this up because I've been completely reading this whole series and everything. I got every single book of Blade Runner 2019, but honestly, I started flipping through it, and I'm like, I don't recognize this, so maybe it's just something different they're doing just for Free Comic Book Day. I'm not for sure. I'm going to read it. I'm going to go back and check out the others, make sure, you know, that I'm not wrong here. Read it, review it, let you guys know. I've enjoyed Blade Runner 2019 so far anyway, I guess I could just leave you with that. So getting into my comic book pull list for the week, starting off with Marvel, as always, we've got Star Wars Darth Vader issue number 4. Guys, this series is almost over as far as I know. I believe this is only a 5-issue miniseries of Darth Vader, and how could I not buy this Darth Vader? I mean, it's Darth Vader, right? Shouldn't this be good? I don't know. I read the first issue, then I fell behind on 2, 3, and, well, now 4. So I'm a couple issues behind, but we're going to get caught up. We'll do some reviews. You know, I'm not the hugest Star Wars fan. I mean, I grow up loving Star Wars. I do love Star Wars. Darth Vader is obviously great, but, you know, I probably need to read more Star Wars here on the channel. I mean, I'm a nerd, right? Right? I don't know. And now, moving on now, I know there's going to be somebody out there that's going to say something. Somebody's going to say something to me about everything and the big deal I made about all this, right? I know somebody's going to. Maybe I'm looking at you aggressively, relaxing. I don't know. Am I? Anyway, this next one right here is one that I've made a big deal about, guys. But here, you know what? You guys know me. I'm not a pushover, but you know what? I spoke and they listened. Marvel listened. So here we go. We got Hawkeye Freefall issue number 5. That's right, guys. That's right. I went ahead and picked it up. Ooh, go ahead and let me know down in the comments below. Say, boo, Trinity. Boo, you went ahead and picked it up after that big deal you made about it. Of course I did. Because I told you guys in the first place, all I wanted was a printed copy. Just finish out the arc. That's all you got to do. They did it. They listened, right? Shouldn't they be rewarded for that? They like, come on. Don't act like they shouldn't be. Don't give me that. Don't you dare give me that, okay? I feel like I'm talking to my kids right now. Anyway, guys, moving on. The next one I've got is another one of those. That is the Revenge of the Cosmic Ghost Rider issue number 5. That's right, guys. I know you're sitting out there thinking I made a big deal. I did make a deal of it. And the thing is they listened. They put out the books. That's all I wanted, right? Shouldn't I be happy with that? Shouldn't you be happy with that? Shouldn't you not be in the comments right now giving me a hard time because, oh, you said Trinity. Well, no, I just said I wanted the printed copy, man. I wanted to read the book. I didn't want to just buy the digital versions. I don't have any problems with digital comics, but, you know, when you stop doing your print book in the middle of an arc and then, you know, you want me to go out there and buy the trade paperback instead when I've got, you know, 4 issues sitting. You get it. You get it. Okay. I'm not going to go. I've gone into it enough. All right, guys. Moving on. We'll move along. Let's move along. All right, we'll move along. The next one I've got here in my Marvel books. This just looks a little weird. I'm not sure what this is doing here. But that's Marauders issue number 11. The Dawn of X continues, guys. Ooh-wee. I can't wait to get into this one, especially given that cover and just everything that's been going on here in Marauders. Marauders, one of my favorite series going on in the Dawn of X books. Hey, what can I say? I'm excited. I'm waiting for it, just like this next one. That is X-Force issue number 11. Oh, man, I swear this is probably the definitive number one in my Dawn of X catalog of the ones that I like. X-Force has been really good. Some interesting things going on here in the past couple issues of X-Force. Has there not been? Oof, man. You need to go back. You know what, guys? If you haven't already read House of X, Powers of X, Powers of 10, whatever you want to call it, go back and read it. I'm going to be doing some videos going back through some of those, kind of breaking them on down and seeing how it relates to everything that we're seeing in all of these Dawn of X titles. I think there's a lot that we kind of, not necessarily that we miss, that we forget about as the series has gone on here. You know, like, it seems like it's been so long ago now. It's been about a year. And I guarantee I went back and I read some of it and I'm like, ooh, I'm seeing some stuff here. Noticing some stuff that, some of the stuff that I really remember and some of it that's really starting to come to fruition, I guess you could say. I don't know. The next one I've got here is Captain Marvel, issue number 19. You know, guys, I've talked about, you know, I'm a few issues behind on this one, but I'm going to get caught up here, do some reviews. I'll probably stop pulling this one, probably issue 20, whichever is the end of the story arc, you know, somewhere around there. Which, of course, is tying into Empire, so it's probably going to go on 21, 22, 20, you know. Yeah, 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 right? Flood them shelves, right? Hey, calm down, guys. It's all right. I'm kidding, because this is one of the ones that's doing it right here. This last one, that's Amazing Spider-Man, issue number 46, guys. I went ahead and picked this one up. You know, I know there's the Mark Bagley variant, and I was going to kind of decide when this came out if which one I was going to get. I think it was a Bagley variant. But I seen this one, I'm like, I actually like this cover. I think I'm going to go ahead and go with the 8 cover here. I don't know. Sometimes it takes seeing it in person, right? Now, that's all I've got for Marvel. Moving on to DC, we've got this, ooh, Dark Knight's Death Metal, issue number 3, guys. I need to probably do some reviews on these things. The thing is, it's hard for me to do reviews on these because I'm not really big into the DC universe or anything like that. You know, so for me, I read this and I enjoy it for what it is. It seems like a Elseworlds kind of thing, but there's other people who don't feel the exact same as me. And, you know, because I don't really understand and realize everything that's going on in this book. So, but, hey, I thought it's kind of silly, kind of slapsticky. I'm not sure. I mean, am I going to finish out this series? Isn't it only 6 issues? 7 issues? I don't know. It's not bad. It's a little silly. The next one and the last one on my DC comic book pull list, guys, is this one right here. Hawkman, issue number 26. I was looking at the B cover that they had on this one, but I went ahead and got this one. I like this one just a little bit more. The B cover was a little too, I don't know, just I just didn't like it as much. So I'm going to go ahead and give this one a read. Now, that's not all that I've got for my DC books this week, because there is another one. Remember, I've been talking here on this channel about how DC, Deceased, has been putting out, you know, those little tie-ins, the Deceased Hope of World's End. Well, issue number 7 just dropped on the DC app today, so I went ahead and got it. They're only 99 cents, guys, tying into everything going here in these comics. How could you say no to this, right? They're only 99 cents. It's a buck. Don't be cheap. Come on. And they're tying in really good to everything going on in the DC, in the Deceased series. I mean, they just weaving a nice story together. But anyway, that's just if you ask me, and I'm not even big into comic books. You guys know me, right? You know me. Now, that's all I have for my Marvel and DC books. We're going to go ahead and get into some small press and indies here, and we're going to start off with one of my favorite publishers. This is Aftershock Comics. This week, we've got Join the Future, issue number 4. Guys, I have really enjoyed this series a whole lot. Just seeing what's kind of going on here. It's kind of got that dystopian future kind of thing. It's almost kind of cyberpunky, and it's just like, it's got a lot of little elements in here that I like about it as well. It's got a main, the main character is a female protagonist that we're dealing with here, and I know there's probably a lot of people out there, you know, you see that, especially these days, you're like, oh, she's got to be a Mary Sue, right? Well, no, I mean, she could be, but this girl in this book, she's being betrayed, she's kind of getting her butt kicked, she's learning her lessons, putting in her dues, I guess, for what's going on in this story. I like Join the Future. I really do like this one. This being issue number 4, I think this is only a 5-issue miniseries, so I think issue number 5 is going to be out, and I think that's the last of it. There's a whole lot to wrap up in these last couple of issues if it's only going to 5. I can't wait to read this one. It's going to be a good one. I'm telling you. The next one on Aftershock Comics is Undone by Blood, issue number 4. Or Shadow of a Wanted Man. This is another one just like Join the Future. I've kind of enjoyed the realism of it because there's this girl who's been wronged. And, you know, again, the same thing. You think, like, oh, she's going to be a Mary Sue, right? Well, you go in and you start reading the book. And you know what? This girl's like, she's getting her butt kicked. She's getting her ass handed to her. She's kind of a smart mouth. She's a little insufferable, all of those things. But you know what? It's a good story. It's a good book. It is. I've been liking Undone by Blood. I can't complain. And I think I could be wrong. You know what? Should I sneak in here and see the last page of it and see if this is actually the end? Is this the end? And it looks like it's the end. Yeah. This is the last one. I knew it was. I didn't think it was going to be an ongoing, but you know, most of them always go 5 issues. Sometimes 4, just depends. That's all I have for my Aftershock books this week. Okay, now we're going to get into one of my favorite publishers I've been telling you guys about here. That's AWA Upshot. That's The Resistance, issue number 4. Guys, this one, I think I've read most of the preview for this one as well through some of those Upshot Now books. I really do enjoy this series. I can't wait to read this full book of issue number 4, because I think I only read part of issue number 4 as a preview. But J. Michael Straczynski doing a good job in here. Mike Deodato Jr. Doing a good job with the art in this book. I really do like it. It's kind of like the X-Men, but a little bit different after a pandemic has swept the world and just kind of, you know, it's killed a lot of people, and it turned some people into superheroes, right? Almost kind of like the X-Men, kind of like the Inhumans. Anyway. You get me. That's all I have for the AWA Upshot books this week. Now, there are a couple that released. I'll probably get them digital and maybe have them order them in here later. The next books I've got here are going to be on Boom Studios Comics. In case you guys haven't been following Boom Studios, they've been knocking it out of the park, really, over at least the last year that I know of, putting out some really good titles and putting out just really beautifully put together books. And this first one is a new one out there, guys. Much talked about. This is that Tom Taylor new one called 7 Secrets. But this is that secret cover, guys. Look at that. See that? I'm going to reveal it to you like this. This is what it cut. This is the cover. This is it. Just the cover. What it's showing you. Look, I'll show you the back cover first. Right there. Right there. There you go. All right. You got the back cover? All right. Okay. Now here we go. Are you ready? All right. What do you think? You like that? I thought it was pretty cool. I snuck a peek before I was getting ready to shoot the video. Yes, I did. I think it's a pretty legit cover. I'm not sure how the book is, what it's going to be about or anything. Kind of got a little bit, you know, from the previews. I don't know. It's Tom Taylor. Tom Taylor's a pretty good writer from what I've read of his books. Can't wait to read this one. Boom Studios Comics. Can't go wrong with that. It's number 1. 7 Secrets. Who knows? I guess we're going to find out. Now, the next one I've got here, another good one on Boom Studios Comics. And I believe this is the last of this series as well. I think this one's a 6-issue miniseries. This one's Alienated, issue number 5. Guys, I've really enjoyed this series. This is another one of those ones where it kind of comes out, and it's kind of like Finger Guns that came out last week. You know, you're sitting there, oh, you got these kids that are out there with their problems. You know, it's a typical YA tale. But then you get in here and see what they're dealing with here. Some of the things that they're going through and the ways that they're handling it. Yeah, it's a YA tale, but some of the things that they're doing in these books, I really do like what they're doing. The writing, the concepts, good stuff. Good stuff out of Alienated Boom Studios, again, with another good title. Now, I can't say that every title they do is great, because there is a couple I found that just weren't for me, but that's, you know, really been largely few and far between. So that's a good thing. The next one and last one here on Boom Studios is Something is Killing the Children, issue number 9. Guys, this is another one written by James Tynion? Whatever. Something's Killing the Children. This one is now an ongoing. It was originally planned to be a miniseries. I've liked Something is Killing the Children, although I've got to say, even as much as I've enjoyed it, I'm not sure how much longer I'm going to keep pulling this one, just due to, you know, there's other books out there, and, you know, how long should I keep up on this series? Should I keep pulling this one? Let me know. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Let me know. Should I keep pulling Something is Killing the Children after issue number 10? I don't know. Maybe I need to reach out to the Myrtle Maniacs. They'll know. Now, the next one I have here is on Image Comics. Image Comics, you know, they put out quite a bit of titles. They've been around for a while. You could probably easily put them up there with the Marvels and DCs, right? It's the big 3, no longer just the big 2, right? Right? I don't know. But this next one is Stealth, issue number 4. Now, I've enjoyed this series so far, just what's kind of going on here. So it's about a superhero in Detroit, but the superhero himself, he's kind of old, he's aging, seems like he's kind of got some dementia going on, he's got some problems. I liked it. I've liked seeing this one. I can't wait to see how this one ends because there's some things going on that, I don't know, I have some suspicions of stuff going on, you know? Don't we do that? Kind of come up with theories of what's going on? I've liked Stealth, one I think you guys should check out. Now, the last one here on my comic book pull list is on Oni Press. This one, you know what? Guys, I'm going to be honest with you. I forgot to read issue number 3. But that's issue number 4 of Dryad. Yes, this one on Oni Press. This is the first book I've ever read by Oni Press. This one has been funny. Just what was going on in issues like 1 and 2. Kind of like, they really kept, like, I was expecting one thing and then they kind of turned it on me a little bit. I'm like, okay, you got me. You got me here. I'm going to keep reading this one. I thought I was going to be done after issue number 1. Read issue number 2. I'm like, okay, all right. Now that's all I got for my comic books this week. There was one I think, you know, maybe it just got shorter, or, you know, just waiting for it to come in. Sometimes that happens, you know. This is a world where all human mistakes happen. But waiting for it's on Red 5 Comics. It's that year, I believe it's Zero Day Threat, issue number 3. Should be coming out. Maybe I got shorter, but it'll be coming in soon. I can't wait to read that one. Plus, I still got to catch up with issue number 1 and 2 anyway, so it's all good. It's all good. Plus, you guys can see it's been kind of a big week here in the first place, right? But anyway, guys, I don't know. That's all I've got for my comic book pull list. Let me know down in the comments below what's on your comic book pull list and what of these comics would you like me to do some more in-depth reviews on, if it's this particular issue, or is there any other books out there that you think I might be reading? Let me know all of those things down in the comments below. That's all I have for this video today, folks. Thank you all so much for tuning in to the Second Street Marvel. If you're not already, please make sure you're subscribed. Click the little bell and all of that good stuff. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Give it a thumbs down if you don't. It's all good. It doesn't hurt my feelings. But you know what does hurt my feelings is when you don't share it with your friends and invite them to come hang out with us here and talk about comic books and stuff. Share it with your friends. Share it with your best friend. Share it with your mom. Share it with your wife, your dad, whoever. Share it with everybody, right? You should do it. And your grandma. Make sure you share it with your grandma too. She might, hey, look at this face. She might like it. You don't know. Don't make decisions for your grandmother. Anyway, guys, you all have a good day, and we'll see you in the next video. Later.